I'm sharing a video today to take a break from work. Recently, I've actually been really addicted to listening to some audiobooks, so I'm almost tempted to do that instead of make those videos. I realized also one thing after feeling that I either want to make sophisticated videos or some videos that actually makes me feel kind of proud. And for me to feel pride, there needs to be relevance in the work that I'm doing right now. So I thought of doing something fun with my past recordings. Let me react a bit to my past attempt using Deltan to Jungle, and then I'm gonna try the same video topic again, so Deltan Jungle, next week, and see what the difference is after all these months of playing AOV. Early game, I actually wanted to go buff to buff, so I leashed out this blue buff a little bit. And you can see it's actually taken me a while to kill this buff. Usually, 46 seconds... No, actually, wait, was it 46 seconds? Something... 42 seconds, usually, people are able to kill that buff. I wanted to try Deltan Jungle because I knew of a way of clearing all three jungle camps together, and then also coming into gank from the sides to a lane usually is so successful for Deltan that I thought, you know, that was gonna be something of an advantage. If I remember correctly, this game was played in July 2019, which was when the blue buff side jungle camps moved around, and it actually messed me up. And so back then, I think I don't end up trying to complete the jungle clears for this reason. Well, for the reason that I might be too slow in the jungle clear. Deltan, however, I think has a very strong early game, and actually this game's gonna be like a 22-8 KDA, just spoilers, but if you get a freeze and a couple of teammates are with you, it's really GG for the victims. So early game, we're gonna just end up with a 3-0-1 lead. Yeah, so watching this back, we were super lucky with this. I mean, my jungle clear is really slow. Now looking at this, I mean, if I was in the vet master level, majority of the people know their hero limits very well, and I probably wouldn't have been able to get such an early advantage on the kills. I'm really interested in making Deltan Jungle work though. I mean, I really like playing this hero. I think its ability to do AoE damage is just so awesome. Can't wait to just do triple kills on people. I think I have a lot of success with ganking on a side lane, so, you know, maybe if I just am a little bit sneakier and stuff like that, we can do it, right? I hope so. Anyway, I almost don't recognize myself playing this game because it really feels that my priority is placed in killing and getting towers. I'm gonna end up going, oh, we have a 4-on-2 advantage, let's just force take this tower. And I would just come here, cut the wave. The idea is good, I think, but I really did miss all my freezes over here, and that's like, unfortunate. We do get this tower though. Spoilers. I mean, it's alright. I mean, it's so obvious we're gonna get the tower, right? Judging from the fact that our Valheim actually survived though, I am skeptical about the elo of this game. I mean, I really think Kulim could have killed Valheim easily, and then the Baldun probably could have just flipped over Thane and hopefully have secured that tower even. Watching back on it now, maybe that tower could have been saved. Right, so in this small moment of calm, let me just mention to you, the reason that we had such a crazy early game, I think, was because our Thane and Valheim ended up walking to the Slayer lane for some reason. And then on their transit back, they ended up helping us catch out the enemies. And for the enemies, it was like, yikes! Dumplings just going one after another into a boiling pot of water. Oh yes, I remember this fight. When the Malak ult came down, I thought, you know, Ryoma would be stunned up, so he would be there. And then I definitely let go of my second freeze way too soon. Every time I thought he would be retreating or something, he ends up like doing some tricks and then he hides in the bush. He was just so slippery. Oh my gosh. Thank goodness the Raz came to end that shameful fight. Embarrassing. Even now, I think there are some heroes that I'm generally just not so confident going up against with Deltan. Especially if their complete focus was just to 1v1 me. I don't know. Like, I'll name a few. Florentino, Ryoma, of course. Who else? Let's see. Murad sometimes? Max. Cooler not so much, you just gotta catch the timing when he comes in to attack you. But really, I've met some Kulins that just completely, every time, dodges my defensive freeze, you know? Yena, when she like jumps out from the bush and then uses her second form immediately, so annoying. So annoying. Okay, I'm done. No, okay, and then Arthur's. Actually, majority of warriors actually get me quite annoyed. And then if they buy the magic boots, oh my gosh. They just come out of the freeze so quickly. These are the kind of engagements I love. Just, they're all focused elsewhere. And then I can just ult people and freeze them and then kill them from the side. Yeah, I really wanted to push the tower, I remember. But I'm pretty sure I could have died here to the Kulin. Next week, I definitely can't be that bold. Just that droplet, I'm 1,500? Like, boom, you're dead. Hi, I'm dead. Maybe Kulin was just too afraid, but I didn't have alt. I mean, I couldn't have done anything to him, really. Anyway, luckily, we got the tower. Valheim, I wanted the buff, and I just don't understand. Why didn't I use the punish? I think maybe I just thought I had Apocalypse already and I could just kill it with my normal attack. But Apocalypse doesn't come out that soon. Okay, I'll have to be aware of this next game. Anyway, thanks to Valheim though, we get a nice lucky freeze here on this Kulin and finish it with that one fantastic buffing Kulin in hand. And then I see an opportunity now to also take out this Ryoma, this really slippery Ryoma. So here we go, let's slow him down and okay, nice freeze. 2-1 ult. There we go. Yeah, avenged my previous embarrassment. Nice. Yeah, I also noticed I ended up buying Hecate's Diatom first. Which isn't normally what happens. Maybe I ended up... Did I exchange the... Yeah, next week I'll also change up my build order. Because I think what I'm more used to is being able to just have that normal attack be a little bit more potent. So, probably not Hecate's Diatom first. I'll probably go with the previous kind of item builds I have, which is your Boomstick, your Apocalypse, right? Then go with some... Oh gosh. That was scary. I thought... You know, I actually thought someone was gonna cancel my ultimate there, but ends up being Thane pushing the Jinar into us with the ult still spinning. Yeah, that ended up well, but... I guess that's gonna be one thing I miss about jungling with Diatom Moses, you don't get that flicker. Can't say, just relocate yourself, make sure you don't get cancelled on ult, and make sure you can deal that full damage and kill your opponents. Let's see, what do we do next? Well, it looks like, I'm eyeing the time, this game is supposed to end at around 11 minutes in the game time, and I'm only at 11 kills, so it looks like I have 9 kills more to go in the next 2 minutes? What the heck? Okay. Well, here's one. I'm pretty sure right now my gold is just way too high for them, and we're just walking through them with my ability one. Let's take a look. Okay, I'm guessing I'm gonna take the tower. Yeah. This is pretty normal. Ouch, that Jinar did not die. Oh yes, that's a nice lucky ult. And 2 kills. Okay, so we got 6 more kills to go. Imagine that. Okay. The one is not as hurtful as I thought. You know, didn't hurt that Kulin as much as I thought it would. Okay, another double freeze and ooh, almost a triple kill. If I had, I think maybe watching this, I would have put my Frostbite down right away. But would Frostbite cancel my ultimate? I actually never tried that. Okay, we can try that next game, hopefully. But if I had Flicker, maybe I could relocate after killing the Kyolin first? And then relocate? I don't know. Because I think I was killed by the tower shot, so... Okay, well this is just a gong show. 17, 3 more deaths to come. Ah, yes, I remember this one. So, here I got the Jinar. Just wait for my ability 1. And everyone's gonna die. I could just wait for my ability 1. Okay, that almost looked like a quad kill. Can we count that as a quad kill? Let's count that as a quad kill, shall we? Anyway, I guess I'm gonna have fun next week trying to beat this performance. Yeah, we'll leave it at that. Like and share. Bye.